normally, Dr. Normally, Mr. Chamara and Dr. Priyamada for giving me this opportunity to speak to you this morning. I feel elated and honored for having associated with the ICLIM for the third time out of the four editions of this event. I remain grateful to the Department of Library and Information Science, University of Kelenia, and all the concerned for this opportunity. Coming back to the track four of the conference, that is inspiring research, innovations, and best practices for sustainable library development. As a library professional, I have been associated with the Training Academy here in India for the last 20 years, and I have had experiences related to innovations, best practices, and working towards sustainable library development. All of us are aware, today the libraries are characterized as dynamic and vibrant places and spaces in which learners cast in their role as discursive consumers with manifold of mutable needs and expectations are socially and academically networked, supported, and developed in a myriad of ways. The traditional library collaborations are being replaced with public partnerships that ensure inclusion as they enhance the vibrancy and sustainability of communities and to promote sustainable information development strategies for all groups within the society without marginalizing any category. Right? As such, libraries are at the juncture where new digital technologies and emerging pedagogical practice blend and operate at different levels and in different environmental settings. In very recent times, this evolving paradigm has been disrupted by the COVID-19 health crisis. Libraries have proven to be very key response agents in reaching out to the stakeholders to the augmentation of existing digital practices, while at the same time pushing the boundaries with respect to digital technologies. Moreover, the COVID-19 restrictions on society have certainly heightened awareness of the importance and the value of library as an equal physical entity comprising different social and interactive spaces and zones serving multitude of needs that we have already experienced during this pandemic. Libraries employ a range of approaches to gather intelligence on how learners use and feel about their library spaces and environments. The success of this evolution will be contingent on the creation of inspiring and attractive services for libraries, collections, activities, and spaces. To remain competitive, one has to be innovative, right? So innovation has moved from consideration to a necessity for academic libraries operating under the dual pressure of economic contraction and technological development. Of course, this which we have been experiencing for over a decade now. So libraries should be open to different types of innovation, including new processes and relationships, as well as novelty in products, services, and programs. Librarians will have to bring innovation to the task they perform so that their work is used for making knowledge and information resources available for empowering their users and communities which they serve. It is not enough to provide access to patrons using cutting-edge technology innovations. Libraries are also responsible for keeping their patrons safe and secure when they use technology innovations. Some of the innovations might not seem particularly innovative in a real sense because they were introduced some 10 years ago. And nowadays, several libraries undertake these initiatives like library automation, building digital libraries, or implementation of a particular open source software for improving their library services. Laura S.W. in her column stated 5 lessons for libraries looking to innovate in the 21st century, which include People need libraries to be more than information repositories. Libraries can play a key role in preserving and strengthening our democracy. The ways in which librarians perceive and interact with the public is a key determinant to a library's success. Embracing innovation and collaboration and admitting failures are key to libraries' success. Libraries can play a leadership role in revitalizing and sustaining communities. In order to provide innovative services to the users that we serve, we need to first identify the situation that we are in and the situation around us, the environment which we are in, and look for the opportunity to innovate what best suits to our libraries. Users want useful technologies. They are not interested what kind of software, what kind of databases you have. They need information. So, but do not want to waste time on things that do not work for them. Engaging users for alert services by using blogs, social networking tools, etc. New tools and methods that are used for teaching and learning and research and digital will be default. Sustainability is now viewed as vital to the mission of many institutions of higher education, creating a paradigm shift that libraries can help advance with their collective interdisciplinary expertise. Librarianship particularly lends itself to the sustainability movement that thinks on systems. So we need to focus more on systems, so this can be achieved through research, innovation, and practicing the best initiatives that are working around us. The sustainability movement is a natural fit for librarians who tend to excel at gathering, synthesizing, and disseminating information as well as communicating across the disciplines. Until unless we communicate the kind of collection that we have, it is not going to serve any purpose to our communities, user communities. So librarians lead users to the authoritative information, enabling them to be effective sustainability activists, to be agents of change. So librarians can be counted as agents of change if you work towards sustainable library development. So librarians benefit from collaborating and coordinating sustainability efforts within their own profession so that they may inspire and sustain one another as well as those they serve, libraries and the user community as well. So the member states of the United Nations adopted 17 sustainable goals. These are popularly known as SDGs. We all are knowing about them. So in September 2015, to tackle the world's biggest problems, such as poverty, protect the planet, and ensure that all people enjoy peace and prosperity by the year 2030. So libraries play a key role in improving outcomes across the SDGs. So libraries provide universal literacy, provide access to information, advance digital inclusion, preserve and provide access to the world's culture and heritage, serve as centers of research, and much more as we do, as we experience. So libraries working to achieve specific goals, SDGs, in their communities should analyze their collections to ensure they adequately support economic, environmental, and social development. So the International Federation of Library Associations and Institutions, ICLA, has been documenting SDGs stories from various countries through a dedicated website known as Library Map of the World, right? So you can access this website from the IPLA site, right? So the other associations in the forefront include ALA and ALIA, Australian Library and Information Association, and American Library Association. So here I would like to share with you that I have come across a calculator developed by Natalis Cardoso, a Brazilian librarian and researcher, to know how our libraries are contributing towards sustainable development goals. This calculator society to achieve sustainable development goals. So the purpose of this calculator is to provide insights into the topic to encourage more librarians to think about actions and implement them in the libraries. So the calculator can be accessible at librariescience.de. Now I would like to focus on another important aspect of development of libraries, that is on green libraries. So the creation of green libraries is approaching a tipping point, generating a green library movement, which is comprised of librarians, libraries, cities, towns, college and university campuses committed to greening libraries and reducing their environmental impact. Some of the green library features include natural daylighting, shading to filter direct sunlight, solar panels, sensors that control indoor lighting for improved energy efficiency, and bamboo wood flooring. So a simple green step that libraries can do for the health of the planet and their employees is to quit using toxic chemical cleaners and switch to environmental friendly cleaning products. Several initiatives have already been taken towards going green by the library associations, such as So can I continue?
Yes, okay, you can continue, sir. Over to you.
Okay, all right. I was speaking on the green library movement. Mm-hmm. So several initiatives have already been taken towards going green by the library associations, such as American Library Association and Special Library Association. So the focus in academic libraries has been shifting towards research and scholarship as developments in digital humanities, data curation, and open science have created opportunities for librarians to extend their roles in the research arena, which has resulted in several collections of case studies documenting emergent practices and innovative strategies for research support. The developments in information literacy, instructional design, peer-assisted learning, and open educational resources have also produced case studies of new and improved practice. Research in librarianship could be based on integration, inspiration, and innovation. I would like to repeat saying that research in library science could be based on integration, inspiration, and innovation, so that we would be in a better position to serve our user community. So these are the very three keywords that we have, that we need to ensure while focusing on research towards development of our libraries, right? So S.S. Pulla states that we do not need to have to do research, original research, in order to apply wisely the results of research by others to improve our practice, and further adds that library practice research is frequently disparaged. However, potential solutions to problems we face, even in an online era, are rooted firmly in the history of the practice of librarianship. The principles of information organization, which are, of course, indexing, collection management, archiving, and user need analysis, can be applied to the current problems that we face. We have a very rich heritage of research and practice to draw upon. And just because work has been done in a past year before computers, and just because it is not accessible via the web, doesn't mean that work has become irrelevant, redundant, right? So the technical tools at our disposal may be more capable and more precise. However, our intellectual heritage is strong, and we should not deliberately go about reinventing the wheels, right? So there are many exciting opportunities for libraries to further develop and enhance their role as partners in and pioneers of academic and scholarly research. These require changes around how research is viewed within libraries, how the library is perceived within their institution, and a focus on building the research capacity and visibility of library colleagues. Conveying the values of the library. So what value the library holds during the present situation? Value of investment, right? So earlier we used to talk about return of investment. Now value of investment. Changing and declining user needs and demands and keeping up with the technological changes will remain the challenges for libraries to attend to, right? So I would end my talk by saying libraries will not survive only on those users who try to approach, but they have to make efforts to reach out to the user community by knowing them well through inspiring research, innovations, best practices for sustainable library development. So grateful to all of you for your patient listening. Thank you all for this opportunity, and I hope you will have fruitful deliberations during the session. Thank you very much. Thank you.